Hey everyone, welcome back. We've got some juicy real gossip for you today. So, it seems like Megan is losing sleep over the thought that her former bestie, Jessica Maroney, might spill some serious tea about their past friendship. If you haven't been following, here's the scoop. Jessica recently dropped a vague but intriguing message on social media hinting at her ability to cut ties, and this comes 3 years after her fallout with Megan. The tension originally spiked during the BLM protests. Lifestyle blogger Sasha Exeter called out Jessica for her actions and what she termed white privilege. Throughout this drama, Megan chose to remain quiet and didn't publicly back Jessica. Since then, they've been pretty much estranged, with no public appearances together. But here's where it gets interesting. Insiders told Closer magazine that Megan is pretty worried about Jessica possibly dishing out some secrets about her and Harry. It's been a stroke of luck for Megan so far, avoiding any major reveals from past friends. A source close to the situation said, Jessica knows Megan through and through. They were inseparable for a decade. The big worry for Harry and Megan is someone from their close circle going public and causing embarrassment. Adding fuel to the fire, another insider claimed in the Globe that Jessica has been biding her time to share her perspective on being marked by Megan. Jessica's apparently prepping to write a book, anticipating it'll be a hit. The angle here is about bringing the truth to light, giving a voice to those who feel wronged by Megan. Angela Levin, a royal commentator, chimed in on Twitter, saying, "It's high time someone showed those two what it's like. It seems like the royal drama isn't cooling down anytime soon." Alright, folks, let's dive deeper into this royal drama. The plot thickens with Megan possibly feeling the heat as she faces potential revelations from her former close friend, Jessica Maroney. There's a saying, what goes around comes around, and it seems like it might just be Megan's turn to experience the other side of the story. The irony here is pretty thick. Megan and Harry are known for sharing their side of things without much care for how it's received. They're all about their truths, but this time, Megan might be on the receiving end. Unlike the kids in Harlem who were restricted by NDAs, Jessica has no such limitations. Some believe that Megan hasn't always been truthful about others, so the possibility of Jessica shedding light on Megan's real character is causing a stir. Why would Megan be so worried if she has nothing to hide? That's the million-dollar question. If Jessica spills the beans, it might just bring some peace of mind to those who've been questioning Megan's narrative. Imagine uncovering all the secrets Megan has been hiding. There's a sense of fairness in this, as some see it. If Megan and Harry can openly criticize others for profit, why can't others do the same to them? This situation could be seen as poetic justice. It's believed that once one person speaks up, others will follow suit. There's a growing perception that Megan isn't the type to maintain genuine friendships, but rather, uses people for her benefit and discards them when they're no longer needed. Jessica learned this the hard way, and many are eager for her to share her experience. Megan's credibility is under scrutiny, with accusations of lies about her past, education, family, and her time with the royal family. The belief is that she's willing to step on others to climb the ladder. Now, with Jessica potentially coming forward, the world might get a glimpse into the real Megan. Moving on in our royal saga, there's a lot to unpack about Megan's climb up the social ladder. It seems like real friendships aren't her forte. Instead, she's drawn to those in higher positions or with more wealth, seemingly as a strategy to boost her own status. Critics like Piers Morgan have labeled her and Harry as grifters, particularly pointing fingers at Megan. Now, there's talk that Harry might be having second thoughts about his marriage. Some speculate he's looking back at his past and wondering if he was better off before. If Harry were more insightful, he might have reconsidered his decision to marry Meghan or even avoid the relationship altogether. But, the theory goes, Meghan has an almost maternal control over him, managing every aspect of his life. This control, however, hasn't brought her the recognition or respect she seeks. Despite her efforts, public approval seems elusive, perhaps due to a lack of humility or compassion. As for Harry, there's a sense that he's trapped in this situation, with some even suggesting he's being mistreated by Meghan. This alleged devaluation phase in their relationship is raising eyebrows about what Harry's next move could be. And now, let's see what our audience thinks about this complicated relationship. Carmen Adams commented that Harry needs to go back, implying a return to his former life. Haria, another viewer, notes that while love is supposed to be wonderful, it can sometimes bring a lot of pain, suggesting Harry should reconsider his situation. It's clear there's a lot of concern and speculation about the state of their relationship. Let's delve into the viewers' perspectives on this royal couple's situation. Love, as many of you say, should be a beautiful experience, not one where you lose your identity. This seems to be the case with Harry, who many feel has lost himself in his relationship with Meghan. Danielle made a remark about a particular photo of Meghan, expressing a less than favorable opinion. It reflects the sentiment that Harry lacks the courage to leave the relationship, with some humorously suggesting he might find his courage in Meghan's handbag. Gwendolyn chimed in with a wish for Harry to return to the UK with his kids, leaving Meghan behind. But, as many of you pointed out, they don't have children together, which complicates the situation further. Kate London offered a thought-provoking take. She believes that no marriage can withstand the pressures of removing someone from their home country, family, and friends. Harry, once a beloved prince in the UK, accustomed to royal privileges, has seen a stark contrast in his life since moving to the States. Kate thinks the marriage could have thrived if they had achieved significant success in America, justifying Harry's sacrifices. But, as she pointed out, that hasn't been the case. The dramatic shift from global admiration to becoming the subject of ridicule, according to Kate, is a significant strain on any relationship. These comments reflect a common sentiment: Harry's drastic change in popularity and lifestyle since marrying Meghan is seen as a severe downfall. If these issues don't make Harry reconsider his choices, it's hard to say what will. The audience's views paint a picture of a relationship fraught with challenges and public scrutiny. Continuing with our discussion, the audience has a lot to say about Harry and Meghan's situation. Irish Channel Girl pointed out that Harry once had the luxury of his father paying his bills and supporting his lifestyle, a stark contrast to his current situation. Charmin expressed agreement with a series of clapping hands emojis, indicating strong approval of the sentiment shared. Diane humorously dubbed Meghan as Meghan the Destroyer, saying she's the only woman to kiss a prince and turn him into a frog, a twist on the classic fairy tale. Gemma added that Meghan is not only seen as a laughingstock but also as the most hated woman in the world, questioning the viewpoint of those who don't share this sentiment. Mountain Spider brought up an interesting point, noting the couple's unrealistic aspiration to become the King and Queen of America, a title unlikely to be accepted by Americans due to their disinterest in royalty. Danielle Grow Up chimed in, defending Harry by saying he chose this life in America, a place where he can do things he couldn't in England. But the sarcasm was evident in the question of whether those activities include being made fun of or being a social pariah. Hart believes Harry will never leave Meghan, especially because they have children together, suggesting he is committed regardless of the circumstances. Kes shared the sentiment that Harry's return to the UK would be unwelcome, especially after an incident where Meghan allegedly disrespected the late Queen. This sentiment, Kes believes, is shared by many Brits. Finally, Pocket Nunu expressed skepticism about Harry leaving America, indicating a wait-and-see attitude towards the unfolding drama. These varied opinions paint a picture of a complex situation, with the public divided on their views of Harry and Meghan's life choices and their impact. Let's dive into more of what you all think about Harry and Meghan's current situation. Pocket Nunu is keeping an eye out for Harry's potential move, believing it might happen eventually, though it hasn't yet. No Wire Hangers, what a creative username. They believe that the couple's portrayal in South Park was a significant blow to their image. Kirsten humorously wishes for a South Fork intervention, while Agnes thinks they've been in trouble for months, lacking the self-awareness to realize it. Irene hopes for another South Park episode featuring the couple, echoing the sentiment for more satire on this topic. Delilah reflects on the couple's failed American dream, suggesting their plans backfired spectacularly. ET2 comments on the uncomfortable nature of watching Harry's emasculation and isolation, labeling their brand as toxic toast. Sheila brings a different perspective, suggesting Harry is equally responsible for their situation. She raises a point about the potential financial implications for British taxpayers if Harry were to return, though she also notes that the royal family's wealth might mitigate this concern. Gregory offers a more critical view of Harry, suggesting he needs to show courage and realize his role in Meghan's strategies. If he hasn't understood this yet, Gregory implies Harry might be lacking in judgment. These comments reflect a wide range of opinions on the couple, with viewers speculating about their future, financial concerns, and the impact of their public image. It's clear that Harry and Meghan's situation continues to be a topic of intense public interest and debate. Continuing our deep dive into the royal couple's saga, let's see what more of you had to say. Gregory suggests that if Harry hasn't realized his situation yet, it could indicate a serious lack of judgment on his part. Wonder Woman, aka Dolores, believes Harry might need some serious reprogramming, a sentiment echoed by others who wonder who's up for such a task. Pimco and Irene also chimed in, with Irene suggesting the need for a petition. WF raises a question about Harry's future, pondering where he could possibly go, given his current reputation. The Viper also points out the dilemma Harry might soon face. Sue and Susan Burns share their views on the couple's dynamics, with Sue noting Harry's tendency to go running back to Meghan. Susan hopes to avoid another chapter in their ongoing saga. Liz appreciates the satire in South Park's portrayal of the couple, particularly the Worldwide Privacy Tour episode. Paula shares a thoughtful perspective, labeling the couple as materialistic and pointing out their lack of appreciation for internal strength and family bonds. She notes that forgiveness doesn't mean forgetting past actions. Goofy's love and another comment from Gregory reflect a sense of hopelessness for Harry's future. Gregory believes Harry has lost any chance of being trusted again due to his actions over the past 4 years. Princess of Archetypes suggests that Harry might be being blackmailed, suspecting Meghan has something on him. Lindy, on a darker note, fears Harry might be more valuable to Meghan in a tragic scenario, a thought she admits is frightening. Susie Grash questions Harry's current position and future prospects, reflecting the uncertainty surrounding his and Meghan's situation. Your comments reveal a broad range of opinions and speculations, painting a complex and often troubling picture of Harry and Meghan's current state and future possibilities. Continuing our journey through your thoughts and opinions on Harry and Meghan's intriguing saga, let's see what more of you have to say. Susie Grash wonders about Harry's welcome in different places, suggesting that their separation might have been ongoing for a while. Hayes expresses happiness for Harry, believing the relationship is over. Hannah compares the couple's story to a dramatic telenovela, full of unexpected twists and turns, even likening Meghan to a character reminiscent of the Joker due to the bizarre nature of events. Karen's comment is filled with a mix of humor and frustration. She bids them farewell in a colorful way, expressing a sentiment shared by many that they are no longer welcome. Jane Brown brings up the children, suggesting they are the reason Harry wouldn't leave Meghan. She speculates that Meghan could use the kids as leverage over Harry, a thought that sparks skepticism from others. Annette Hugh, Charlotte, and Sharon share their views, ranging from cautious waiting and hopefulness to a call for Harry to start working and earn his living, much like Princess Anne's children have done. Debbie and Anne Campbell express doubts about the couple's situation, with Anne specifically questioning the existence of their children until proven otherwise. Z-List Mattress Actress, another user, bluntly labels them as failures, summarizing the general disappointment felt by many. Your comments showcase a diverse range of perspectives, from skepticism to humor, to outright disbelief. Each of you brings a unique viewpoint to the table, highlighting the complexities and controversies surrounding Harry and Meghan's public life. In this latest segment, your opinions on Harry and Meghan's journey continue to be as diverse and intriguing as ever. CYN suggests Africa as a potential haven for Harry. They believe the people there still hold a lot of love for him and that the continent could be a true test of what's real in his life, especially if Meghan were to join him. The consensus is that Africa's values might not align with Meghan's, highlighting a cultural clash. Barbara and Summer share brief but hopeful sentiments about the situation, while Marie isn't surprised by the developments. Janet ponders the implications of their rumored separation, especially concerning the children and potential child support issues. She questions where Harry might go and who would welcome him. LJR brings a different angle, speculating that this could all be a PR stunt by Harry to maintain his UK residency and work visa in the USA. There's curiosity about the specifics of Harry's immigration status and whether he's in the USA on a work visa. Joe expresses a strong opinion against Harry returning to the UK, a sentiment seemingly shared by many. Cumminger raises doubts about Meghan's PR team's efforts and Harry's decision-making, suggesting that he made a significant mistake. Your comments paint a vivid picture of the complexities and global implications of Harry and Meghan's situation. The varied perspectives offer insight into how different cultures and individuals view their story, with opinions ranging from hopeful to critical. Wrapping up this segment, let's highlight a few more of your insightful comments. Kamindra Euro's sentiment echoes a common theme, suggesting Harry's decision to be with Meghan might be a regret he's carrying. This idea reflects the notion that his current predicament is a direct result of his choices. Susan Waters brings a pragmatic perspective, stating succinctly that if the money disappears, Meghan's commitment might too. Her comment cuts straight to the heart of many speculations about the couple's relationship dynamics. Thank you, Susan, for your straightforward and impactful comment. Your input, like that of all our commenters, adds valuable depth to our discussion about Harry and Meghan's ongoing saga.